A cure comes with some specific challenges. The most significant of these challenges is the virus's ability to hide itself and lay dormant in pockets of host cells that are unrecognized as harboring HIV by the immune system, even if an individual has successfully suppressed their HIV through antiretroviral drugs. The hidden HIV can reemerge if antiretroviral drugs are stopped. The most successful cure of HIV was accomplished via gene therapy, which entails knocking in protective genes to a person's immune cells that would protect them against HIV. The gene donor is usually a person genetically protected from HIV, meaning they have the protective gene. Though gene therapy may be complex, I have a good news for you before the end of the video. Please note that the cure and the treatment discussed in this video are based on standard medical procedures with appropriate ethical approval. We know what those protective genes look like because some people are naturally born with them. These people are protected because they don't have a receptor called CCR5 on the outside of their immune cells. HIV needs these receptors before it can enter and infect the body. Thus, these people cannot be infected with HIV. For example, the Berlin patient. He received a stem cell transplant after he was diagnosed with leukemia. The stem cells given to Berlin patient were from a person who was naturally protected from HIV by having genes that lacked the ability to produce a functional CCR5 receptor. He did very well after and was considered cured of HIV. A similar procedure appears to have been successful in two other people. The first one is known as the London patient. The second person, called the Dusseldorf patient. They both received a bone marrow transplant to treat leukemia. They were declared cured of HIV in 2023. Please subscribe to our channel so that you can be notified when we release a new video. Another similar technique using stem cells from umbilical cord blood. In early 2022, researchers announced that a fourth person, and the first woman, has been cured following a procedure. This patient was also diagnosed with leukemia. She underwent a transplant using stem cells from umbilical cord blood, but from an individual with a CCR5 mutation like in the three previous cases. She has been in remission without HIV medications. In mid-2022, a potential cure of an older person, the City of Hope patient, was announced. He had lived with HIV for a long time, and after a stem cell transplant has been free of HIV without treatment since 2021. What if the stem cell is from someone without the protective gene? Two other people living with HIV and cancer who received stem cell transplants to treat their cancer are commonly referred to as the Boston patients. These people stopped taking HIV drugs for a couple of years after their transplants and were able to go for several weeks or months without the virus reappearing. Unlike the London and Berlin patient, they did not receive donor stem cells from a person resistant to HIV. As a result, although they appeared to have no evidence of HIV after their transplants, the virus ultimately returned in both of them after they stopped taking their HIV drugs. Sometimes the outcome is not what we expect. Another person with cancer who had a stem cell transplant, the Geneva patient, has remained without the virus for 20 months after stopping antiretroviral therapy. He had started HIV treatment early and had an undetectable viral load for a long time before receiving a transplant from a donor who did not have the HIV protective CCR5 mutation. His viral load remains undetectable, but very small amounts of defective virus remain. Researchers therefore call this a case of HIV remission, not cure. Although a few people appear to have been cured of HIV under special circumstances, there is currently no general cure for this virus as researchers proceed with the quest for a cure. We are currently closer to a cure, which is likely going to involve a combination of techniques and drugs. Now to the good news. There is a new drug which has the ability of killing HIV reservoir cells in our body. If this drug works well, cure might be achieved without gene therapy. Our next video will explain more on this. Please subscribe to our channel so that you can be notified when we release the next video. Note that, knowledge is advancing by the day and we will like to always post an update on new advances on how to stay healthy. You can contact us via the link in the description below for any medical inquiry. You are watching Zoom Hospital channel and listening to work of Dr. Kayode.